Hi, I'm Adeline from Singapore, and I'm currently pursuing a part-time creative writing master's degree at LaSalle School of the Art. The short story was inspired by a personal family incident of mine. My grandmother passed away a few years ago, and she left behind a flat with no will. And with 10 sons and daughters, it's very difficult to figure out what to do with the flat. Because in land-scarce Singapore, keeping a flat for sentimental reasons isn't as straightforward as it seems. So I was interested in writing a story in which conflicts arise, not because of purely selfish motivations, but rather what each character deems to be the right thing to do. So I hope that you will enjoy this story, as I will enjoy the stories of all the other writers in the anthology. And I look forward to meeting you guys at the Singapore Writers Festival.
Hello, my name is Ariba Sabiha Nasser. I'm an Indian author. I live in Canada with my family. I am thrilled and honored to be a part of Singapore's Writers Festival and the anthology. My story, The Bench, revolves around loss, separation, which eventually leads to mental illness. I have been wanting to write something on mental illness and the loss of a loved one for quite long, and when this opportunity came to me, I combined the theme of mental illness along with the theme of the anthology, and the result is The Bench. I hope you guys enjoy reading it. I am not going to go deep into it because it's going to spoil the story. I hope you guys enjoy reading it. Have a good read. Thank you so much.
Thank you, everyone, for joining me. And thank you for Kitab and the Singapore Writers Festival for having me back after my near daily presence there for 4 years. So my story, Turquoise Water, White Liberal Guilt, is a story of love and travel, and also a quiet examination of, you know, something that wouldn't answer to a bureaucratic word like citizenship, and is probably better thought of as modes of belonging. I don't discount solo travel as a writer and reader. I'm a huge believer in solitude, but there's so much of travel that works well with love. You know, the sharing, the celebrating and commiserating, the proper use of a hotel room. And so my story is a story of travel and love. And it is, in practical terms, what John Gardner calls a win story. You know, stories end in win, lose, or draw. And I'm with Shakespeare, a win is love. And many of these same themes are available in my new novel, Our Sands, just out with Penguin Random House. Thank you.
Hello, my name is John Gresham. I'm the author of We Rose Up Slowly, and the co-editor with Elizabeth Tan of In This Desert There Were Seeds. I'm honored and blessed to have a story selected for Kitab's Best Asian Short Stories 2020, and to be a part of this virtual launch at Singapore Writers Festival. My story is called Dog at the End of the World, which is about a golden-haired retriever, a Labrador retriever locked in with their mistress in an executive condominium in Singapore at the time of a pandemic spreading throughout the world. It is a canine perspective on dystopia. Long-standing loyalties are questioned as everything falls apart. What happens if you're cooped up inside a condominium for months? Can you trust your mistress? Will anybody rescue you? Who will survive as darkness falls and chaos reigns? The values of decency and kindness fall away in a dog-eat-dog world. Thanks again to Kitab for publishing my story, and I hope you enjoy it and the others in the 2020 anthology.
Hi everyone, my name is Kelly Kaur. I'm delighted to have my short story in the Best Asian Short Stories 2020. And my story is entitled The Singapore Dream. I was drawn to the theme of migration. You see, as an immigrant myself, a homesick, displaced Singaporean living in Canada, I wanted to grapple with the questions of what do immigrants feel when they leave? Do they want to come back? Do they miss what they left? Do they crave for what they want? I think this is the immigrant dance, the idea of the theme of insider and outsider. And I hope that you will read the story, and if you're an immigrant, empathize or see what us immigrants go through. Thank you.
Hi, I'm Karen, and I live in Singapore. Despite everything being turned upside down by COVID-19 this year, I'm glad the Singapore Writers Festival can go online, and I hope it attracts even more participants internationally this way. My story in the Best Asian Short Stories anthology is called Borongorap Man. It was inspired by a family trip to a remote part of Western Australia, especially one day meeting a man whose dog had gone missing. And then all of us reflecting in hindsight later, hey, you know, was it just me, or did you guys also think he was looking at our barbecue funny? Kind of as if it has something to do with his dog. So it was a quirky incident. It got me thinking about people and places, what kind of influence the land can have on people. I hope you enjoy it, and I'm looking forward to seeing you at the Writers Festival.
Hello, this is Murali Kama speaking to you from Atlanta. I've been to lovely Singapore just once, but I hope to be back in the near future. I'm honored and delighted that my story has been included in the Best Asian Short Stories 2020. Congrats to Kitab for completing 15 years as a promoter of Asian literature. This year's theme appealed to me because although I'm a naturalized US citizen now, I grew up in India. In this story, I wanted to explore how an immigrant like me would or should react to the demonization of undocumented migrants. I wanted to talk about inequality, borders, compassion, grit, the media, perseverance, and responsibility. Nonfiction seemed a little daunting, but fiction appealed to me because you can imagine the lives of others and show in an understated manner how ordinary people react to challenges and circumstances beyond their control. Thank you.
At the height of the American colonial rule in the Philippines, one man places his stake on an untamed and remote territory whose bounties he thinks will profit him. The countrywide train construction has begun, and before him is a possibility and a promise that Flagstaff and the train station will be built right within the land he had just purchased. After more than a century, we see the remnants of these dreams and his struggles to control or fetter the wildness of nature. So in this story, I've explored life in the countryside and how the government and capitalists have made the situations of the farmers worse than before, and worse over the years, in fact. Petty landowners are still struggling to transport their crops to markets, and decades later, nothing much has changed.
Hi all, I'm Seema Panwani from Singapore. I'm writer of novel Cross Connection, and also I'm doing my master's at La Salle College of Arts in Singapore. This is the second year that Kitab has published my short story in the Best Asian Short Stories anthology. Spin is a story from interconnected short stories that I'm currently working from. It focuses on a relationship between a father and his 8-year-old autistic son. Autistic children are not abnormal. They just have a unique and a different perspective towards life and beings. Neurodiversity is a concept that human beings don't come in one-size-fits-all normal packages. As a society, we need to be a lot more inclusive of individuals with autistic and treat them with the respect and the dignity that they deserve. My short story Spin also aims to shed light on parents who are raising children with autism. Sometimes the prevalent prejudice in society today deters them from doing what's right by their child. Through my collection of these interconnected short stories, I aim to give voice to the marginalized groups in society. I hope you will enjoy the story. Thank you.
Hi everyone, my name is Ong. I'm a Vietnamese poet and writer based in Singapore. I'm very glad and honored to be included in the 2020 Best Asian Short Stories anthology. My story is called As Legal As We Are. It surrounds the human infallibility of a gay drug abuser on the verge of finding love. So I wrote the story in the hope of raising awareness about an issue that is increasingly prevalent in Singapore. So I hope you do like the story. If you have any feedback at all, please do tell me.
Hi, I'm Yap Sunyo. My story in Toke Lee's mansion describes the life of a wealthy Peranakan family seen through the eyes of Rosita Wati, a young Indonesian girl whose Mark worked for the Lee family. She could not understand why Mark, a highly educated professional, would want to take on the job as a maid. Mark, however, has her reasons and eventually achieved her objectives. I enjoy reading. I also enjoy writing short stories, mainly fiction, that is, fiction based on facts, as most stories are. Thank you.
Hello, I'm Mazam Sheikh, and I'm the author of the short story Sunshine, which is included in the upcoming Best Asian Short Stories 2020. And I'm very excited about it. I would like to briefly tell you the idea that created the story. And it really has to do with the apprehension or fear, for lack of a better word, that I feel a parent might feel towards your own child's growing up and entering adulthood. And before you even blink, the childhood is gone, and you're grappling with this sudden absence or emptiness, if you will. I hope you get a chance to read my short story and enjoy it. Thank you so much.
Hi, my name is Farah Ghaznavi and I'm from Bangladesh. My story, Saving Grace, is set behind the scenes of a 5-star hotel somewhere in an unnamed country in the Middle East. The protagonists, who are from Sri Lanka and the Philippines, are about to find out just how spectacularly life can go off the rails when you least expect it. It kind of mirrors my writing process for this story because it was the first time I had the experience of having a character change midstream and take over my carefully plotted story so that I was left with something very different at the end of it. Nevertheless, I'm happy enough with the story and it was a very fun ride. So I hope that you will enjoy reading all of the stories in this volume as much as we've enjoyed writing them.
My name is Jasmine. I wrote the story, A Woman's Place, to actually talk about migration in a very different sense. We always look at migration from an adult point of view, where adults make the choice to migrate and move to greener pastures. My story of migration is about circumstances and about the children who are actually young migrants. So I wrote the story to show that for a woman, their choice can be their own, and that wherever they may be from, whether they are migrants or born within the same family, that there is always hope, there's always possibility. Yeah, thank you.